going to be discussed about the increasing soil fertility with the help of microorganisms. Yes. And let's revise some more last class topic, vaccines. Who discovered the vaccines? Edward Jenner discovered the vaccination. And who discovered that vaccines for all the scientists discovered after the Edward Jenner in 1798. He discovered the vaccination for the smallpox, and later so many scientists came under to know that the microorganisms are also going to be produced the vaccines to control the infections and bacterial diseases, and came to know they are going to invented more vaccines for so many diseases that we discussed in the last class. And also we discussed about that the vaccination sheet, the list of the vaccinations are given for them from the childhood to 3 to 9 years, that the chart we discussed in the last class about the BCG vaccination, polio, tetanus vaccination, varicella vaccination and diphtheria, MMR vaccination, river vaccination, that and all we discussed in the last class. And also we discussed that the vaccinations are going to be kill the infections and to provide the antibodies against in our body to fight the bacterial infections, that and all we discussed in the last class. And the government also is going to be helpful for the people to giving more awareness on the vaccination at the right time given for the children. These and all we discussed, children. And today's class we are going to discuss about the increasing soil fertility. Well, how the fertility means what? The fertility means sufficient chemicals and components needs to be given for the plants to get more yield. That is the fertility. Generally, the crops, the first crop from January, I grown some crop. March, I will be plucked it. Again, April, I will be sow. June, I will be plucked. From crop to crop, we are continuously taking the food from the soil. The soil also may get some loss of energy, no? Loss of nutrients from the soil, no? That thing we are giving, that's why we are spraying the manures, fertilizers and some urea at the certain times to get the more yield. Not only by adding that, some microorganisms are there to regain the fertility of the soil. And some of the microorganisms when we are giving for the soil will be increase the soil fertility. The best example of microorganism is going to be increase the soil fertility is rhizobium. Rhizobium. Agarobacteria. These are the best examples of microorganisms from the bacteria. The soil, what does it do? It enriches the nitrogen fixation occurs in the soil. Okay, it will enrich the nitrogen present in the soil. Wherever the nitrogen is very deep layers in the soil, it will be came near the roots by using by the microorganism of Rhizobium and Agarobacterium. Where these Rhizobium bacteria will be present? It will be in a soil. Mostly these Rhizobium bacteria will be seen in leguminous plants.
Did you observe any time that nodes are nothing but
is so yum. The dosa are nothing but rhizobium. These rhizobium are going to be absorb the nitrogen from the soil. This direct nitrogen the plants are not going to take. The nitrogen is going to be split into nitrates and nitrites. Nitrates and nitrites. These only the soil will take and it is going to produce the more proteins into the plants. Yes, here the rhizobium and the agrobacteria is to be increasing the soil fertility. Now the microorganisms are helpful. Yes, helpful. When the rhizobium is there, it will be helpful. If the rhizobium is not there, it is not going to be helpful for the plants. And next. Yes. When I am childhood time, my gardener, what he is doing, he collected some waste fruits and he collected some vegetables and he collected some dried leaves and he kept in one pit. This is a garden and some area is there. In that area, he dig one big hole and he kept the dried leaves and the vegetable waste and the plant waste and he filled it with soil. After 3 weeks, he dig the waste from the pit and he spread it on the plants. Spread it near the soil of the plant and the plants are growing. How it is possible? Yes, see here. To understand that, I am going to tell you one activity. Children, you should also do that activity in your home if you are having any garden. If you want to create your own bio manual for your plants, we should do this. Take two parts, name it part A and part B. In first part, you should fill with what you need to be filled: dried leaves, waste vegetables, and waste fruit. Fruits means that the pea or the seeds like that, children. And next, some dead plants. Dead plants. These and all kept it in a pot. Now I kept it and filled with soil. Soil, not the mud. Soil, filled with soil. After that, one more layer. dry leaves, waste vegetables like that. And sprinkle some water. Close the lid and kept it aside for 3 weeks. And take part B, fill it with plastic covers, plastic bags, and the glass bottles. Fill it here in part B. And kept some soil. Sprinkle with water. At the time when you sprinkle the water, again you should close with the help of lid. After closing these two parts, kept it aside for 3 weeks. After 3 weeks, what did you observe? You got a smell from part A. You got a different type of smell, and some organisms also will be grown. Some insects will be crossing near the part A. Yes, dig that part A manure and spread it near your garden area. This manure is going to be produce some microorganisms. That microorganisms are going to be helpful for the increasing of soil fertility. Did in our home also we are doing the same thing. What we are using? That the dried plants and the flowers where we are getting from the puja room, no? That waste flowers, all we are kept in a one big basket filled with the soil. After 1 month, we are getting down and crushed it with a big stone, and we are going to be throw that small amount of manure to every plant and watering it daily. These organisms are going to be produce some small insects. That is, except that examples we may take as an rhizobia and some entomons also, there will be a chance to produce the manure, to convert to normal leaves to manure. And these entomons are going to be helpful for the soil to dig them good soil from the deep layers of the field to upside. That's why the entomons are going to produce when we are using the normal manure, bio manure. When we are using the outside fertilizers and chemicals, the entomons cannot be alive in soil. It will be dead. Why? The chemicals will kill the insects, right? Yes, the entomons also will be killed by using factories chemicals. That's why the farmers are trying to use the manure only. Nowadays the government is also going to be recommended for the farmers to use limit amount of manure, less quality of chemicals and fertilizers don't use for the crops. Why? Because the good things are there, some insects and some pest control insects are there in the soil, that the earthworms all will be killed why we are using the chemicals and fertilizers. This is the activity, children. If you want to do this activity for your maintenance of your garden, you should be use this type of method. Don't let the waste throw it outside from your houses. From what you are having in your house, the waste should be kept in your garden aside and use that manure for your plants. It is going to be get the more flowers and good smell flowers by yourself only. And this is the activity, and we discussed about increasing the soil fertility by the microorganisms that are rhizobium, cyanobacteria, and the agrobacteria. The rhizobium bacteria are having more in the leguminosity plants. That leguminosity plants are nothing but the groundnut pea. These microorganisms are going to be enrich the nitrogen present in the soil. Get it in near to the roots, and the roots are getting that nitrogen for the plant. It is getting the more proteins. Yes, and already and again we discussed about that these fertilizers and manures. In the first lesson we discussed how much the yield we may get by when we are using the fertilizers and manures, and what are the causes, pollution causing when we are using these fertilizers and the less causes harmful were at the time of using man use. We discussed in the first lesson time, and these microorganisms are also going to be clean the environment. How it is going to be clean the environment? Some microorganisms are there. That microorganisms, when you sprinkle with the help of sprayer on the dust or mud, it will be kills the germs. And that microorganisms try to decompose. Decompose means like a paste, it will be formed, and that the decompose material we can use for the fields. That is about the increasing soil fertility, microorganisms. And in the next class, we are going to be see the harmful microorganisms. Up to now, we discussed only the good things about the microorganisms. What are the good things? The microorganisms are going to be helpful for the fermentation of the food, and it will be act as a probiotic. And in probiotic means nothing but yogurt and the curd only. Yogurt and curd, when we are eating, the body can produce more antibodies. That is the probiotic. Okay, and the antibiotics will be helpful for the antibiotics. Microorganisms are helpful to invent the vaccines, and these are helpful for invent the increasing the soil fertility. These and all are the uses for the microorganisms. And in the next class, we are going to be see the harmful microorganisms. With that harmful microorganisms, what are the diseases we are going to be cause? We will see in the next class, children. Thank you, children.